charging equipment looks like. If it looks like this, I don't recommend using it because this CCS connector is all beat up over here. This should be replaced. This is a safety hazard right here. And hello and welcome back to Simply Greg's 3EV. I often get asked, how fast do EV chargers actually get fixed out in the field? A lot of you have been wondering about a recent video I filmed right here at this charging site that we come to very often. Basically what happened was the CCS handle was completely destroyed. It was properly knackered. It looks like somebody had been chewing on it or some sort of animal had been chewing on it. And it wasn't very safe. So what I did was I filed a ticket with Circuit Electric. This was July 27th. We were up here filming the Fiat 500e charging test, which you should check out. And I filed the ticket for broken equipment on July 28th at around 4 p.m. Didn't hear anything back for 48 hours. They finally wrote back saying, Mr. Gregster, thank you for your concern. Somebody we'll look into it and get back to you. And I said, well, they're not really going to do anything. I posted the video on TikTok and various social media. You see it here on YouTube as well, where a lot of you were saying, well, that's not that bad. It's not broken. And I'm just overreacting. The pins are fine and so on and so forth. Well, I believe on a 29th or 30th, I got back a message saying that the ticket had been opened to replace the equipment. And today we are, what are we today actually? I think we're the 7th. Sorry, we're Wednesday, August 6th. And at work today, I was checking my notifications on my phone at around 4 p.m. and it said that the incident and file was closed at this site. And I'm like, well, did they actually go up and change the equipment? So let's find out if they actually managed in what, about a week and a half to fix the charging equipment here. Let's go see. We actually came up here to film two videos, the auto charger plug and charge video, but this was the subject of that original TikTok that I posted that the equipment was broken. Well, if you look here, so it's been roughly, let's say, a week since the ticket has been opened. This is a brand new charging handle here, folks. Look at this one, brand new. Only been used a few times, still wrapped in plastic. So they replaced the entire cable. So it took about a week to get the ball rolling, but they definitely replaced the handle and the cable. That's a brand new CCS1 connector. And if you also remember, this was pretty broken as well. They just drilled two holes and put a big zip tie in. To be fair, that's what I would have done too. So yeah, hats off to Circuit Electric here. They put a brand new cable in with a handle and it's perfect. So it took about a week to get this done. Super, super cool, super fast. I do know a lot of people were complaining about charging providers not keeping their infrastructure in good condition, not repairing it. But I think a week, or who knows, this might have been fixed a few days ago, but they only closed the ticket now. But regardless, from filing it, it was just over a week. So super, super, super good. Would I have liked to have seen it faster? Well, I'll let you in on something. I reported a broken J1772 connector by my house and Hydro-Québec had it fixed within 24 hours. There was a new connector and a new cable on that post. So somebody at Circuit Electric, Hydro-Québec, awesome job. Super, super thankful that they got this fixed quickly. I'm not going to make this a terribly long video, but there was interest in people wondering how long does it take to get fixed. I know I keep saying this, so it took about a week here. I think that's really good. Could it be better? Possibly, but I don't really have anything to compare it with. But I will say this, if you see broken charging equipment, it doesn't matter if a network, Circuit Electric, Electrify Canada, Electrify America, Tesla, any of the charging providers, any of the CPOs, if you see broken equipment, report it, because there's not a lot of people from the CPO that are driving around checking the equipment, I'm sure of that. So it's up to us EV owners to report broken equipment. However, I can't believe how quickly they fix this. And to be fair, I didn't even think that they would fix it at all because it was still accepting a charge. It's just, it was in really bad condition. Like I said, properly knackered, like someone been gnawing at it. Yeah, maybe that's an animal or, but yeah, it's been dropped. It was dropped a few times.
super impressed. Circulatrix, solid job. You guys got it done, and you got it done quick at a very high powered site here. Hopefully other charging providers, they could learn something from this. If you maintain your infrastructure, if you invest in infrastructure, people will actually use that infrastructure because they want a good seamless experience. And they have auto charge, plug and charge enabled now, so it's even better via network. So solid job, Circuit Electric. You got the ABB handle changed. Super impressed. Hope you found this video interesting. And please like, comment, share, subscribe. Comment below if you've ever had broken charging equipment that took forever to fix, or was never fixed at all, or they just took the charger offline and then it vanished to who knows where. So leave that comment below. Make sure to subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video. Have yourselves a good evening or a good day from wherever you're watching. Bye for now.